Hello, welcome to the Nebraska Health Network Outpatient Antimicrobial Stewardship Education Module, presented by the Nebraska Medicine and Nebraska Antimicrobial Stewardship Assessment and Promotion Program, ASAP. I am Jasmine Marcellin, an infectious diseases physician at the University of Nebraska Medical Center and Associate Medical Director of the Nebraska Medicine Antimicrobial Stewardship Program. This education module is a two-part series. In this presentation, we are going to talk briefly about why antimicrobial stewardship in the outpatient setting matters. In the second presentation, we will discuss diagnosis and management strategies for select upper respiratory tract infections commonly encountered in the ambulatory clinic. Let's start with a little background on antibiotics. Antibiotics were an amazing discovery and have led to a tremendous impact on medicine. In the pre-antibiotic era, mortality from simple skin and soft tissue infections was significant. The introduction of sulfa antibiotics, followed by penicillin, led to a substantial reduction in mortality due to these infections. Antibiotics are unique drugs, a shared natural resource that must be preserved for future generations. Compared to a drug like an antihypertensive, for example, they are the only drugs that lose efficacy over time and need to be used sparingly to preserve efficacy. And they are the only drugs where my prescribing practices affects whether or not the drug will be efficacious for your patient when you prescribe them. In modern medicine, the use of antibiotics have allowed us to successfully perform organ transplants, complex surgical procedures, and care for extremely preterm infants. These interventions have been successful because antibiotics have allowed us to prevent and/or treat infections in these critically ill patients. Unfortunately, we now live in an era where the utility of these amazing agents is threatened by the emergence and spread of antimicrobial resistance. So what is the significance of antimicrobial resistance? In 2013, the CDC tried to quantify the effect of antimicrobial resistance in the United States with its Antibiotic Resistance Threat Report. In this report, they tried to estimate the impact in terms of tangible outcomes such as deaths and Clostridium difficile infections. About 2 million people per year develop illnesses due to resistant organisms, and from that population, about 23,000 people die per year due to infections with antibiotic-resistant organisms. Similarly, about 250,000 people per year develop C. difficile infections, with about 14,000 deaths per year arising from these infections. So this is a significant contribution by antimicrobial resistance to both annual morbidity and mortality. Antibiotic use is the key driver of antimicrobial resistance, and we know that even after just 4 days of using antibiotics, our patient's throat flora can be changed to become resistant to commonly used antibiotics. But how much do we prescribe in the outpatient setting anyway? A 2016 study demonstrated that almost 13% of outpatient clinic visits resulted in antibiotics, with almost half of these prescriptions designated for respiratory conditions. Additionally, it has been estimated that up to 30% of outpatient antibiotic prescriptions are unnecessary. This graphic of 2015 data from the CDC compares ambulatory visit antibiotic prescriptions by state. The deepest red indicates the highest antibiotic use. Zooming in to our own state, Nebraska, we are above the national average in outpatient antibiotic prescriptions, with 1,045 antibiotic prescriptions dispensed per 1,000 population. These statistics are terrifying, but how do we deal with it? The first response would be to create new drugs. However, this is not as straightforward as it seems. In the past 6 years, only 7 new antibiotics have been approved by the FDA. In 2017, there were only 24 new or repurposed antibiotics in late-stage clinical development, and no single antibiotic candidate claims to have activity against those bacteria resistant to all currently available drugs. If we can't make new drugs easily, we can combat resistance by controlling the spread of resistant organisms, which is the principle of infection control, and out of the scope of this video. However, if we truly want to get to the heart of the matter, we must change the way we use antibiotics, and this is the premise of antimicrobial stewardship. Antimicrobial stewardship describes the processes to optimize the use of antimicrobials through interventions to guide clinicians on appropriate antibiotic selection, timing, dosing, and duration. Antimicrobial stewardship focuses on both patient and public health goals to cure or prevent infection, minimize adverse events and antimicrobial resistance, and ultimately reduce treatment costs. Recall that as a state, Nebraska has one of the highest rates of outpatient antibiotics prescribed. This figure shows antibiotics prescribed by a primary care clinics in Nebraska over a one-year period for the diagnosis of acute bronchitis. This is a diagnosis where most major specialty organizations recommend no antibiotic use at all. However, there is a seasonal trend showing high numbers of prescriptions for macrolides, followed by fluoroquinolones and aminopenicillins for the diagnosis of bronchitis. The previous figure demonstrated that we have a lot of room for improvement, and this is where empowering prescribers and patients to avoid unnecessary antibiotic prescriptions will be essential. As clinicians, we have many reasons to care about antibiotic stewardship. Due to the ongoing issue of antibiotic resistance, in 2014, the President called for a 50% reduction in inappropriate outpatient antibiotic use in his National Action Plan for Combating Antibiotic-Resistant Bacteria. The Joint Commission wants us to care. They have required antimicrobial stewardship in hospitals and hospital-based ambulatory clinics, and soon the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services will too. Our patients want us to care, to avoid medication side effects, toxicities, and to preserve antibiotics when they are really needed. Finally, we should care because we pledge to do no harm. This is a problem that we as humans created. Therefore, as clinicians pledged to take care of our patients, we should be eager to reduce or reverse any potential harms that are within our power to do so. So as we close this part of the presentation, remember that we can all play a part in preserving the antibiotics we have for future use by being conscious prescribers and offering alternatives when appropriate. Citations for guidelines or data quoted in this presentation are listed on individual slides referencing the information. For any questions regarding antimicrobial stewardship initiatives in the outpatient setting, feel free to contact any of our team members listed here. Thank you for your attention.